So, people, I may have found or got exposed to the best package manager for Arch Linux out there. And I got shown this on a live stream by one of my viewers, and it's done by a community member of the Endeavor OS people, and I think it's in the AUR, and it's basically called pacseek. And here it is. If you're living in the command line, pacseek is actually really, really amazing. So let's just do VLC. And then you just use your arrow keys and you go up and down. You can see here it takes both in from the AUR and the normal repository. And then if you want to uninstall it, you just click enter. If you want to install something, you click enter. And pops your uncle, everything is just working. Let's go up again here. Let's do Parmac. Here we have Parmac from the AUR. So I can just go down here, click enter, and you can see over here. You can show the package build, you get some descriptions, some information about what the package is doing. We can go up and do Krita. You see here we have the app image, we have the beta, the git, the minimum, the next bin. We can even go in here and you can see dependencies. It's like it gives you everything you want. And as far as I know, this is done in Go, the Go language. And again, it's done by a community member of the Endeavor OS team. I couldn't remember the name right now. So if we go up here, we could search pacseek. We can see if it's in the AUR. I must admit, it's almost better than Parmac or Muon, or not Muon, Occupy and all that shit. Is it a terminal tool? Yeah, but it's actually really, really useful. I don't miss the point and click. I can show you guys how to install, how it looks like when you install something. So let's do, I have no fucking idea what we should install. Abbey Word. Or maybe we should, there you go, Abbey Word. So we have it in the extra here. So I just click enter here and then I have to put in my password. And it's basically showing us we want this. So it's basically just a front end that then go back. It basically go in and activate the Pac-Man backend or the Yay backend, and then it install it. And if you want to uninstall it, you just again say again, and then it starts installing it. It's actually really, 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 really neat. I think it's Control N to see the. Yeah, here you can see the shortcuts. Enter. We can go in. We can Control S to show the options. You can go in here, and then you can color scheme. Don't want that use. I just use tab to go up and down here. Border style, save layout window, disable the AUI if you want. AUI timeout. Yeah, a lot of fucking amazing things in here. The database, what commands you want to install, upgrade, remove. So it's using Yay as its backend. If you don't have Yay, you can just put Pacman up there. So Pacman space dash capital S, Pacman space dash capital RS, you know, show package build initially, disable news feed. Like, if you're a terminal fucking junkie, this is as good as it gets. This is as good as it gets, if you ask me. It's like, yeah, when I saw this, I was actually blown away. Another great thing coming out from the Endeavor OS people. They seem to do a lot of great things. And this is not specifically the Endeavor OS distribution, but someone from within the Endeavor OS community. If you want to learn more about this, go into the Endeavor OS forums and whatnot, and you will probably get some feedback to pacseek and talk to the developer in there. It's I like it. It's fucking great. It's a terminal tool that don't look like a terminal tool. So there's updates, by the way. You can actually go in here and show a list of upgradable packages. Control G. So we are going, Firefox is going to be upgraded, and libde is going to be upgraded. And I think there's a way to show list of all installed. There's a way to upgrade. I can't seem to remember it right now. Yeah, perform system upgrade, Control U. So now we are upgrading. I want this on my Ubuntu distributions. I really want. It's really neat. This reminds me of Yast a little bit, you know, of the quality and the thought that the open source people put into their things. So if there is not a Debian version of this, I may go and seek down the source code and learn enough Go to see if I can convert this into a Debian program also. may not have the skills for it, but if someone out there have it, go ask if you can do it. Again, a lot of people that are running Debian or Ubuntu-based distribution, which is the majority of Linux users, and they love, you know, their terminals and what have you not. Heck, I could even see this being useful on a Ubuntu server or Debian server or Red Hat server, for that matter. You know, have a little bit of a front end to do administrative work. So can we even see how big it is? It's under the MIT license, unknown maintainer. It depends on Pacman, XGT, util, fake root. I love this. So please go check it out. Please go into the Endeavor OS forums and be part of the conversation in there. Or if he is in another place, Mason Moe, I think his name is. If you look at the URL here, so this is the dude that makes it. It's amazing what people come up with, man. Go check it out. See you all later. Bye-bye.